Ground effect is when an airplane gets close to the ground and it experiences more lift and less drag, which is great. And in fact, there's some vehicles that are called ground effect vehicles that are designed to fly, always fly within a few feet of the ground. So that in my mind, they're not true airplanes because they cannot fly away, but they fly in that zone of higher efficiency. So they're pretty efficient. But anyway, getting back to airplanes, ground effect doesn't start until the airplane is within one wingspan of the ground, but you're really not going to notice it until you get a lot closer to the ground than that. And what you may not know is that it's two entirely unrelated effects that are at play. The first one, which is what causes the reduction in the drag, is actually a reduction in the induced drag. An induced drag is when you have the higher pressure on the bottom, the lower pressure on top, and it comes together at the wingtip, and there's a vortex that forms, and this vortex is lost energy, and that's the induced drag. So when you get real close to the ground, there's two things that happen. One is that the vortex is pushed out because, again, it's close to the ground, so you get an effective increase in the wingspan of the airplane. But the other thing that happens is that the ground interferes with the vortex formation. So the vortex is not as strong, and again, that leads to a net reduction in drag in the airplane. So this is proportional to the height of the airplane, but also to the wingspan. And the other effect that we call ground effect is the increase in lift. And this increase in lift is actually happening under the airplane because it's sometimes people call this a ram effect, which is the air is hitting the bottom of the airplane, but the ground is right there, so it doesn't have too many places to go. So there's an extra increase in pressure on the bottom of the airplane. So the net effect of that is that you get more lift. And you know, the reduction in drag because of the reduction in the induced drag over the wings, it could be half, and the increase in lift, you could get double the amount of lift. And it's not unusual for an airplane for the lift to drag ratio to double, which is really good. Of course, the caveat is that only happens when you're pretty close to the ground. So we tend to see that. I mean, I tend to see that when I come in for a landing, but sometimes a full size airplane will take off and wait there a little bit because while it's in ground effect, it can actually fly slower than the normal stall speed, okay? So then you can gain some speed and then climb out of ground effect. And that's a neat trick. You have to be careful when you do it, but it's a way of getting up into the air sooner than you normally would be able to. And till next time.